Hi, hello everyone. This talk is about telecom bell, which is a connection manager for Ring. So, anyone of you are wondering why such a strange or weird name, I'll explain that as well. So let me introduce myself. Short introduction. I'm Alok Anand. I'm maintainer of telepathy bell. I'm a computer science student, third year in India. I've worked on telepathy bell in my Google Summer of Code project recently in 2016. So, as I already mentioned, this was my Google Summer of Code project. I had some excellent mentors. The idea was proposed by Daniel himself, and he was involved with ABM, and he was also working on telepathy reciprocate. So, and Stephen Salimkovic was a member of Shibuya Linux Ring team, and Alexander Akulich, who is an active maintainer of telepathy QD. So these three people guided me throughout my project. I think the slides have been started.
The slides visible here?
Yeah, you can see them. So, you can continue.
So, I actually cannot see the updated slide on my screen. Is the telepathy connection manager question mark? Right. Together this common framework, and So there are several components to this modular framework. We'll have a look at the major ones from the perspective of GPT connection manager developer point of view. There's a connection manager, which is the service which forms the pluggable protocol backend part of the framework. And these service can allow other communication services like text, call, etc. And the client will be the application that user uses to interact with the telepathy framework. The example would be Geo, which is available to empathy, which is available in Geo. And then KD has KD Empathy, which is a simple extra environment, KD. And there are other relevant components which you don't need to go into details right now. I'll mention them for completeness. So the account manager and channel dispatcher. So while looking at this overview, you can see that this would be the in a typical MS desktop, this would be the case for eBus, which is used to share all the signals, events, messages, etc. And all the services. On the top half, you can see the components of telepathy which are necessary for telepathy. Account manager, channel dispatcher, logger, etc. And on the lower half, you can see what more relevant to us, such as which would be the connection manager, and other connection managers can exist on that as well. Telepathy client and within this space, and other applications which are connected to eBus can also there. So this is the general overview in the Linux system of what all things will be connected to eBus. Telepathy is a very eBus extensive, it uses eBus extensively. Now, let's have a quick look into Ring. I talked about Ring earlier, and I'll also skim through the key points here. So, Ring is a real-time system service. It's open source and it's developed by Signal Linux. So what is unique about Ring is that it uses a distributed peer-to-peer network. Some key points about Ring is it uses OpenDSP. This is where all the magic of peer-to-peer networking lies. And while using Ring, every user will use a Ring ID. So this is just like a SHA-1 hash, 20 bytes, so 40 digits, hexadecimal digits, prefixed by a Ring pool. So this would be a Ring ID. This is an example of a Ring ID. So every user will have a unique Ring ID associated with him on the distribution network. Ring has several files for Windows, Mac, Linux, Android, Apple, everyone. But since we are discussing about Linux here, so we'll go into the Linux clients. It's a GNU project. It's become a GNU project. There was a beta release on November. So fair amount of development is going on in Ring. A small brief introduction into its architecture. So we can say that it has a three-tier architecture. The core part of it is the libring. Here is where the Ring daemon and the DHT lies. We can roughly say that this is the core part of the Ring, the core logic of Ring. There is a libring client, which is common to all the platforms, even in Linux. And that libring client is then used by Ring Genome and Ring KD. So Ring Genome is the official Ring application, while Ring KD is a community contributed version. So there are these both of them are user level application clients for Ring. So why choose a telepathy web? So I have some very simple and straightforward reasons for that. Ring daemon has a very well documented exposed API. So we can exploit that and easily create a connection manager. It makes an advantage. It makes the development process quite easy and quick. Telepathy frameworks are, and its clients are installed it by default in many distributions, such as Ubuntu has empathy installed by default. KD, or as I mentioned earlier, KD also has KD help in its framework. By that, we can say that it would be a lower entry barrier for new users. A new user does not have to may not have to install every the ring client and the application, can directly use the connection manager to create new account and do some basic simple tasks such as calling, messaging, etc. And thereby it reduces the installations that we need to do. Thereby, and connection manager is also quite lightweight, which is not a big problem at all. So this will be the preview of by using telepathy help. As I mentioned, the ring client, as I mentioned, there is a ring client. It also, it also uses the same D-bus, same D-bus API, which is exposed by ring thing. And so can telepathy bell or a connection manager can use that. So simply to interact with ring demon and telepathy client, thereby just reducing this another step. And so as you can see that it can be equally powerful as a ring client. May not have almost all the functions of a ring client, but it can be equally, it can certainly do a lot of basic tasks such as calls, messages, etc. So now, what all things that I implemented, what all things that I did while I was working on a project. The first thing that I did was to create a base skeleton project. I used C++ and I used Telepathy QT as a backend. And then I made sure that I could connect to game daemon, I could use debugs, I could debug, everything was working, and after that I implemented some basic account management functions. So by basic I mean creating a simple account, associating a username or an alias to an account. These are the simple things. And some basic contact management. While I was working on Ring, it did not have the features to support full-fledged contact management. It did not involve contacts as well. So what I did was, during the lifetime of a connection, I could associate any person who calls or any ring ID which there's a message, incoming message or something like this. I could associate with a temporary contact for the lifetime of the connection. So this is what I did with that. It's all there.
One minute, so
Jaminy
has some time to present.
Okay, I'll have it. And although it was not part of the project, I did create a dev package just for experimentation purposes. I did implement basic calls and messaging functions. So I think I may not have a time for a demo, but I think it will make it very quick. So I'll be using my phone to send a quick message to my train client. So I'll be sending, hi, this is live. And let's go to the message. So this is the client and this is the working. This is the logic working here. Still sending a message. Try this once more. Okay. There's a delay because it's the traffic on the network that I'm having. So I'll skip this only here. Well, I did also include some demonstration properties while I was documenting the project. So there is a lot that can be done. Account management, there can be contact management done. Since everything is done over D-bus, it is believed that it will be heavy for a video call, for a high quality video call, but still other possibilities can be looked at. And all other features that Ring will be adding itself can also be added. So I would like to also answer a question which is really important, but why is it in activity online in this connection management? So I've been kind of hoping for Ring to have a stable API since the project only aimed at creating a very bare-bones skeleton for collection manager, since Ring is also being developed fast way. And within no time, there will be a stable idea that I can put back and have significant upgrades into the collection manager. That's why I've been dormant for some time regarding this. Okay, so at last, I will reiterate this Unix philosophy. Do one thing and do it well. But when we are using telepathy, we ensure that we use one thing which is good at doing all the things. So it will help people reducing the massive amount of efforts that they do while creating their own desktop clients for their own services. Most of these features can be extracted and easily integrated into framework, healthy framework. And I would recommend anyone who wants to create a simple client application to have a try and telepathy first. Thank you. If there are any questions, feel free to mail me. I'm also available at GitHub. This is my GitHub profile. This will be my GitHub profile. It's there including the slides. And I will also treat the slides as stuff. Okay, that's it. Thank you.
Any questions?
I cannot see you, but I just, yeah, I can hope that I look as cool as Noor.
Any question for Allo?
Yeah?
No. Okay. Thank you. Hello.
Thanks, Allo.
It was great to have you participate.
Yeah, okay. Thank you. Thank you for having me.
It was great work, too.
Yeah. Thank you.